everyone. Welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. I'm your host, Che Durena. Now, what are some of your biggest fears? Are you worried that you'll never live up to your parents' expectations? Or are you worried that you might die alone and never find anyone to love? Or are you worried that we're all gonna die in the massive climate event that is about to wipe out an unknown amount of the population? It looks like the Earth is heating up and it's going to be pretty rough for most of us. Unless you're a denier and you think that it's not going to happen, it's not gonna happen to you, you're like, no, it doesn't even exist. If you're a climate change denier, then why would you even click on this video? Obviously, I'm going to be talking about climate change and how it's affecting the world on today's list of top 10 scary signs of climate change. As always, I would like it if you guys liked, comment, subscribed, and hit the little notification bell. Also, stick around for the whole list because we've got some points on here that I know you're going to want to know about for your own sake. And if you guys want more Most Amazing Top 10 content before the water levels rise and kill us all, go check us out on Instagram and Facebook. There's so much more content over there for you guys. And without taking any longer, let's get into this list. At number 10, the polar ice caps are melting. Remember way back in the day when climate change was just called global warming, and people back then said it wasn't even happening, even though the polar ice caps are melting every day. I put this at number 10 because it has been one of the longest standing and earliest points to identify climate change. The world is getting hotter, so the ice on top of the world is melting. You don't need a science degree to figure this one out. When things get hot, ice goes bye-bye. The math is very simple. Oh, and I don't know if you guys know this about the polar ice caps, but ancient viruses that we know nothing about, viruses that we could have no immunity to, are living inside the ice caps. When they melt, they will be released into the water supply and spread like that beast in The Thing. So let's play a game of how would you like to die in the climate change apocalypse? Would you like to be eaten by cannibals? Have your body ravished by an infectious disease? Starve to death or die from a natural disaster? Come back after this short commercial break and we'll have the answer for you. At number 9, we have forest fires. If you've been watching the news, you've seen an uptick in forest fires mainly on the west coast of Canada and America. Well, this is from a lack of rainfall due to climate change and deforestation. Because people keep chopping down trees and vegetation, this causes a decrease in what's called evapotranspiration. This is when vegetation releases vapor, which makes clouds, which causes rain. Evapotranspiration contributes to about 10 to 15% of the world's rainfall. So if you chop down a bunch of trees, it makes less rain, which dries out the land and then makes it easier for forest fire to start. This is what you would call a vicious cycle. Everyone, please go plant a tree right now. At number 8, we have smoke pollution. Okay, so we're gonna roll right off the last point into this one. When I originally heard about climate change, aka global warming, I was like, who cares? I like it hot anyway. Or I was like, we could just move north. It's already cold up there. We're gonna be fine, whatever. But what I didn't think about is how the world is going to be falling apart at the seams. The planet isn't just going to be hotter. Every aspect is going to change. A big one being the air quality. In our last point, we talked about the increase of furious forest fires. Great movie title. Well, all these massive fires cause smoke, which even if you live hundreds of miles away, will work its way down to your area. So as the climate change crisis continues to spiral out of control, it's going to get a few degrees hotter. But the air will also become so polluted, you won't be able to leave your homes without doing serious damage to your lungs. I was just hoping for an extra month of summer, but now I gotta worry about poison in the airways. At number 7, we have acidity levels in the ocean are rising. So as carbon gets released into the atmosphere, it will work its way into different aspects of our lives. A big one being the ocean. The ocean is one of the largest carbon sinks on the planet, meaning it sucks up carbon like Squidward sucks up Krabby Patties in that one specific episode. And as we release enough carbon into the atmosphere to, well, kill us, there is an increase in the amount of carbon that is getting sucked into the ocean, which gets turned into carbonic acid, which makes the acid levels in the ocean go up. What does this mean? Well, when the acid levels get too high, you can say goodbye to eating all sorts of fish because they are all going to die. Turns out swimming around in a pool of acid is about as pleasant as huffing one of your dog's farts. At number 6, we have rising sea levels. What causes sea levels to rise? Well, most of you at home are going to call out the melting of the polar ice caps and the melting of icebergs. This is half true. Landlocked ice will cause sea levels to rise as they melt and enter the water. But any ice that's already floating in the ocean won't. It's like an iceberg floating around already displaces an equal amount of water to how large it is. So when it melts, you won't see a large increase in water levels. Like when you have a cup of water with ice in it, as the ice melts, the water level doesn't really go up. But there is a hidden cause of rising sea levels, and that is heat. As the world continues to get hotter, water expands. Just like most things on this planet, when water heats up, it takes up a lot more space. So the more and more the planet temperature increases, the higher and higher the water levels are going to climb. At number 5, we have disappearing marine life. If you're living somewhere for thousands of years and the temperature has been just right, I mean so right you can lay a ton of eggs there and raise a family, but then all of a sudden it starts to get a little too hot and you're thinking to yourself, well that's weird, I've been living here for so long and I've been so used to the temperature until now. Would you stay in that uncomfortable environment or would you go and search for a better habitat? Well, most marine animals are choosing the latter. In the recent years we've seen a rapid decline in marine life outside of the effects of overfishing. What scientists have been observing is the migration of fish to cooler waters. When things get too uncomfortable for these little swimmers, they go in search of a better living situation. And this has a ripple effect. Some of the larger predatory fish don't catch on as quickly. This causes them to go swimming around without food, and then they eventually die off. I mean, if I was a little fish trying to find a new home, I would be really happy about this situation. I bet every guppy is pro global warming. At number 4, we have the increase of methane. It's toxic, it smells bad, and it lives in your butt. He's your poop's next door neighbor. It's methane gas. Methane comes off in all sorts of things. It sneaks out of your butt every time you fart. It flows out of factory farms from all the animal waste that's pumped out of there. But methane also gets into the atmosphere in a way that I bet you didn't even know about. It comes off of ice. Not all ice, don't worry, there's not farts locked away in your ice tray. But in some ice on the polar ice caps and in methane hydrates, which are pockets of ice at the ocean floor, loaded with methane gas. And the beautiful thing about methane is once it's in the atmosphere, it's way more hazardous to the planet than any regular carbon dioxide. It speeds up the greenhouse effect way faster. So if you want to watch the world burn, better get to farting. At number 3, we have changing weather. Well, it's literally called climate change. This would be in the number 1 spot if it wasn't so right on the nose. And if you haven't seen the weather changing, then you have blinders on, my dude, because it has been happening everywhere. Europe just had a massive heat wave this summer, with France and England reaching record-breaking levels. 2 years ago in Canada, the city of Winnipeg was the coldest it's ever been. And this is a city that's notoriously known for being super cold. There's a 24-hour period where Winnipeg was colder than the surface of Mars. Yeah, the planet that is millions of miles further from the sun than we are, it was colder here. And places in Central America are seeing heat spikes that are so serious, people are dying in their homes from heat exposure. I mean, that is the definition of climate change. The weather is changing. The planet is getting hotter. We're all going to die. See you guys at the ration wars. At number 2, we have a decrease in biodiversity. Climate change has a massive effect on every ecosystem on the planet. When one environment is changed too drastically, the animals will leave the area and search for something more stable. It's like when a bunch of dudes go out clubbing and they get in a fight at the club and they're forced to move on to another club in search of good times and casual sex. Like dumb bros, animals will move to a new location, come into conflict with the new inhabitants, and then go to war. This causes certain species to die off and can introduce invasive species into an area, which can wipe out massive amounts of life. It will become survival of the fittest on a grand scale, and we already see this happening. Every day on the news there's a story about a bear walking into town in search of food, or cougars being spotted on the outskirts of a city. Well, maybe this is more common for me because I live in Canada, but trust me, it's happening a lot. At number 1, we have the temperatures are rising. Duh. Let's lay it out there, you guys. The biggest sign that climate change is happening is the world is getting hotter. This isn't up for debate. This is a science. There are facts right out in front of your faces. Between the years of 2010 and 2016, 10 countries recorded their hottest summers ever. CO2 levels are at an all-time high, and if we don't change our ways now, we're going to be having a tough time turning back the clock. On the bright side, I'm going to have a great tan at the end of the world. We're going to be murdering each other with hatchets and selling off children for beans, but at least it's going to be shorts weather. Alright everyone, that is our list. I want to thank everyone at home for tuning in and watching. Remember, if you guys haven't already, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Please do this now because we're running out of time. The inferno is coming. Also, if you guys want more Most Amazing Top 10 content, check us out on Instagram and Facebook. Until next time, I've been Jade Arena, and I think it's time to plan that end of the world orgy. Who's with me?